Thank you for remembering me and my work for the Dalit Muslim unity, not only in Karnataka but all over the country. It was all over. There is not a single state of this country which I have left. Even in remote Assam, I have gone and spoken about it. If I tell you the miracles we did during the period when Dalit Voice was in circulation, you'll be shocked. Have you heard about Maulana Ali Mian Hasan Ali Nadvi of Lucknow? Have you heard about him? He was one of the greatest saints at that time. He is no more. I was his right-hand man. Right-hand man. I used to go to Lucknow very often. And at that time, Ali Mian Maulana Hasan Ali Nadvi was the topmost Muslim saint in the country at that time. You'll be shocked to hear how we two worked together. At that time, Ali Mian was above 80. Above 80 he was. He could not walk properly. More than 1 mile he can't walk. But even then he was coming with me. When Babri Masjid was demolished, I telephoned him and went to Lucknow. Yeah, he was staying in Lucknow itself, on the bank of the river this side. And I told him that we have to protest. He asked me how to protest. I told him that we too will start walking from Lucknow to whichever to distance we can have. He was ready. He was ready. We walked for about 2 miles. After that he could not. He collapsed. Collapsed since he sat there. I had to get him water. Babri Masjid was, even now it remains as a ruin. Kanchiram was my another great ideological friend. Very fine person. A bachelor. He's from Punjab. Today, together, we did great miracles. There is one, Prabhakaran, is he here or gone? Kanchiram toured Kerala once. Then I called Prabhakaran here and asked him to go the whole of Kerala spreading the voice. He was becoming weak and he asked me to take over as the head of the Bahujan Samaj Party. I said, no, it is not possible. It is not possible for me because Mayawati was already angling for that job. Mayawati was waiting for the death of Kanchiram. I will not be able to go into the details of the whole thing. Kanchiram died. I came to know about Kanchiram's death when I was addressing a meeting in Patna. Patna. There's a big maidan in Patna. Somebody came and whispered into my ears, then Kanchiram is dead. Then I immediately told, at that time, the strong man was I am forgetting the name. He was a very popular leader of, even now he is alive. I told him, I engaged a taxi right from Patna to Delhi. When I know the hospital where he was ailing, but when I went there, I was not allowed inside. Mayawati has said not to allow anybody inside. Mayawati has now taken over the whole assets, the properties, the buildings, and everything, and she is playing game with the Congress Party. Instead of joining with the Bahujan Front, she is trying to help the Brahmins. One thing, I spoke to the Jamaat-e-Islami people in Delhi, Muslim League people in Delhi, Tablighi Jamaat people in Delhi, and requested them to organize a joint conference in Ram Leela Maidan, and I wanted to introduce them Kanchiram. Kanchiram agreed. It was a fairly good meeting. I saw the police, plainclothes policemen taking down notes. Immediately after the meeting, of course I also spoke, after Kanchiram I spoke, and I called for the unity of the Dalits and Muslims. If the Dalits and Muslims join hands, the liberation of this country will be able within 10 years. I have been telling it, the friends sitting here, Delhi is there, Iqbal Ahmed Sharif is there, am I right? I have been telling it. They are not taking interest what can be done about it. We have one Maulana, Jafar Ali. Jafar Ali. How many of you know Maulana Jafar Ali here? Awesome. He also died. He was the one man who was standing by me. Wherever I went, we went to Gujarat three times. Three times I went, we went, both of us went to Gujarat. There we started this thing. So, at the Ram Leela ground, I said one thing important. It was a big gathering of Muslims only. Kanchiram and myself were sitting in that. I said, if the Dalits and Muslims join hands, it is like the end of the Brahman War. Next day, Kanchiram came early morning to my room. I said, what is this thing coming at 6 o'clock in the morning, 5:30 in the morning and waking me up? You don't know Rajshekhar. The police came to my room, IT people. Who gave this idea of Dalit and Muslim unity and all these very dangerous thing? You have to be very careful. You have to ever, for 3 months you should not deliver any speech. Dalit and Muslims, if you join hands, Brahmins will leave this country and run away. I spoke about it with the previous chief of the Hyderabad, not the person. Salahuddin. I took the famous smuggler of Bombay, Haji Mastan. I went to Haji Mastan. He knows me. Haji Mastan knows me. Haji Mastan was a real 150% Muslim. He is from Tamil Nadu. A slum dweller went and settled. I took Haji Mastan. Both of us, we went to Hyderabad. We in that vast, you know, place, Darussalam, what is it called?
Darussalam.
That Darussalam, the courtyard itself is almost more than half furlong. half hour long wide, half hour long. Khan, when Haji Mastan delivered his speech, he should see the entire Hyderabad. Haji Mastan was a person devoted to this cause. I brought him to Bangalore, we delivered a speech here. My name is in all the intelligence records. Everybody knows about my intelligence and all that. But they could not do anything because I was a newspaper man. So, I'm just telling you, Dalit Muslim unity is very important. The lead has to be taken by the Muslims. You are our elder brothers. We are your younger brothers. Elder brother has to take the lead and invite the Dalits for all your festivals. Once the Dalit Muslim unity come around, our problems will be automatically solved. Very next, today's organizers of this meeting are mainly Muslims. Brahmins are throughout my life in the Indian Express, Deccan Herald, and in another paper in Delhi, almost all the journalists, 95% are Brahmins. Kancha, do you know this? 95% are Brahmins. You know what they say? Janivara bittaru journalism bidodilla. There are so much. We have got a press club in Bangalore. I am one of the founder members of that. When I was arrested and taken to Chandigarh jail, I was arrested many times. Taken jail, the Brahmins in the press club, they all joined and had a double peg of whiskey. Patrick, you know about it? Double peg. You bolli makka hoda yun barodilla inno indu onu kaiya kalathu. I was taken to Punjab. I was put in a lockup in Chandigarh jail. Next day itself, Siddhartha Shankar Rai, governor, sent his car to the jail. What is this thing? By mistake the police have arrested you. This Rajiv Gandhi telephoned me and said, how you were arrested? What happened to you? All types of confusion. My son was there, my wife was there. Immediately you are shifted from jail to a Raj Bhavan and given in and charged back. The amount of trouble these Brahmins are giving. I am a person known for very outspoken speech. I have spoken like this in Hyderabad also. All over the country, even outside India. I will tell you one thing, what has happened in Libya. We had a delegation, Libya at that time was Gaddafi. Right? Gaddafi. Gaddafi invited a Dalit Muslim team from India under my leadership. One of the persons who came along with me was M.A. Delvi. Will you please stand up? Delvi. Old history. He was one of the persons along with me today. And then Gaddafi delivered a speech for about half an hour. Also he mentioned about me. And then I delivered a speech for only 2 minutes, there's no time there. And at that time, I spoke about the different caste problem in India. Came back to my room and I was very tired and ate something and slept. After half an hour, there's a knock on my door. Knock. I said, who is that? Opened the door. It looks like an Indian. It is in Tripoli, Libya. Who are you? He said, I am a journalist. What journalism are you? I am the representative of the All India Radio. What happened to what made you to come and meet me at this time? You have spoken in your public meeting criticizing Brahmins. Yes. Is it proper in your power to criticize Brahmins in a foreign soil? I was very angry. I was about to hold his neck and kick him out. But I controlled myself and said, are you the owner of India to talk like this? If you are the owner of India, yes, you have got the right. You are also a citizen, I am also a citizen. Yeah. When I reached Delhi, the police were waiting. My passport was confiscated and taken. All the amount of things, only now because what has happened, I have, because the climatic conditions here, for health reasons, I have shifted from here to Mangalore, because which is also a native place. So, I have, that if you, the Muslims here are also facing trouble. Muslims facing the trouble mainly from the Hindu people, RSS and all. You will be able to protect yourself from the enemy if you take the support of the Dalits. Why you are not doing it? Today, Professor Koya and our friends, when they organized, how did they invite us? So many Dalit friends have come here. Dalit Muslim unity will come to at all the things, no. At all the things in your masjid affairs, in your festivals, in different parties that you throw, invite the Dalits. Keep a list with you. Therefore, our friends are there. Iqbal Ahmad Sharif is sitting here. Delvi is sitting there. There are some 2-3 friends here. Take their help and send the invitation. All of them will come. Dalit Muslim unity will take place. I have nothing else to say now because you see already it is very late. You must be all tired. So if there is any real good question with the permission of the, if there is any real good question, sharp questions, if there is any doubt, I am prepared to take it if the chair allows it. Thank you.